consultant at Manipal Hospital, and today I'm going to talk about a commonest problem that occurs for many during this lockdown period, called the backache. Many of us have been introduced to new work or extra work, or we have to change our work style during our lockdown period because of work from home, because we are helping our kith and kin at home, we are helping our family, we are helping our friends. So we are used to doing work that are not our regular ones. So we end up with back pain, body pain, neck pain, headache, too much of stress level. So regarding the back pain and neck pain, let me tell you a few comments. Back pain is very common. So don't worry, just because you've got a back pain, you're going to get trouble. Whenever you get a back pain, all you do is that you take some, you go and lie down in a bed which is comfortable for you, apply some ointments and keep some hot water pack. If the pain is too severe, you can take one Crocin or Calpol tablet and take rest for an hour or two. That should kind of relieve you with your muscle pain. Next, if the pain is too severe, if it's radiating to your legs, if it's coming all the way to your buttock and all to your legs, or if you have some vague tingling or numb sensations in your legs, do visit a nearby doctor. Or if you're afraid that you won't be able to step out of the hospital, your home, take a video consultation with any spine surgeon or orthopedic surgeon, and we will help you out and how you can tackle it out. Back pains are pretty common when you all of a sudden jump into your overzealous exercise workouts. Like all of a sudden someone and say, I challenge you for doing so many burpees or so many squats or so many minutes of planks. When you all of a sudden do all those, it's very common for you to develop a backache or a catch. Again, apply some ointments, hot water packs, rest. That's all is needed to relieve that back pain. Regarding your neck pain, because of either lifting, moving any objects, again, if your pain is only on the back of your neck and it's limiting your neck movements, no pain to your shoulders or any numbness or tingling sensation in your fingers, no need to worry. It's just a muscle catch and you can very well treat it at home with some ointments and hot water fomentation. When you have neck pain, don't use a pillow for lying down. Either use a small rolled towel or a very thin soft pillow for your head. Observe your neck and back pain for a day or two. If you are getting comfortable, nothing to worry. If your pain is still persisting or increasing, do consult a doctor, preferably an orthopedic surgeon or a spine surgeon. When do you have to get worried about your back pain or neck pain? When it's increasing on coughing or sneezing. When you find some alteration in the pattern of you using the restroom, like you are too frequently using the restroom. When you feel that you are developing some numbness or weakness in your hands or legs. When you have associated fever. When you have lost weight. Or the pain is more severe at night when you are lying down in your bed. In these cases, you have to visit the doctor at the earliest. Next, what are all the basic steps to be taken to prevent back and neck pain. Easiest way, and the one that most of us don't follow, is simple stretching exercises. When you get up from the bed, all you have to do is move your head to the left and right, move your head up and down, stretch it to the maximum possible. Again, stand up from your bed, twist your body to your left and right, bend a little bit forward and bend a little bit backwards. This will stretch your muscles. Next, you do these stretches a bit repetitively, say 5 times or 10 times a day. This will keep your muscles active. When you are working on a system or a laptop, say for continuously for 6 hours or 8 hours because of work from home, try to sit on a chair with a good back support. Rest your back on the back support. Don't slouch, don't bend forward. Don't sit on a sofa or don't sit on a bed and then work on your system. That will definitely cause a back and the neck pain. Keep your system at a comfortable level and the monitor should be at your eye level. Your hands should not have any stress when you are using the keyboard. When you are sitting in a chair, half an hour once, try to stretch your leg and try to hold it for 10 counts when you are walking. Again, keep your water bottle a bit far away so that each time when you drink water, you have to go ahead, stretch and take your bottle. This will help indirectly in the movement of your head, neck, arms, shoulders and your back. Take a break once an hour or two. Just go around your home or go to the kitchen, fill up your bottle of water and come back. Or just a few minutes of walking around and then come back, sit and work. Next is how to do your extra works at home. Try to do it in a slow additions. Like if you have to clean your room or clean some space, try to split it over a few days and do it so that you don't strain yourself much. If you have to move an object, if it's easily movable with a wheel, you can very well do it. If you have to lift and do it, get someone's help and then try not to lift it by bending forward. Bend your knee, bend your hips, and like how you sit for a squat, sit like that and slowly lift the object up. There is a high chance for your disc to prolapse if you lift too heavy weight by bending forward or if you try to lift something over your head. The other myth regarding problems with the spine. Not all back pains and neck pains are same. Most of them, around 80%, are simple catch. Another 20% varies between a disc bulge, infection, or any bone that has grown because of wear and tear, which is commonly called as spondylosis or spondylitis. Next are conditions wherein there is some nerve getting pressed because of either the disc or some overgrowth of the muscle or the overgrowth of the ligament or the bone. So the 20% is a bit tricky to kind of find out which pattern has caused you the neck and back pain. So don't blindly follow a video in YouTube saying that if you have a back pain or neck pain, do all these exercises, you will be better. You can try once If you are comfortable, you can try it a couple of more times. But if it's causing you any trouble, do not try it again, because it might increase your back and neck pain. And from a simple treatable problem, you might land up into a more complex problem wherein you will be requiring some intervention like an injection in your spinal cord or a surgery. It's better to get an opinion from a trained spine surgeon or an orthopedic consultant before you venture out into any sort of exercises based on your YouTube videos. Or just by hearsay, someone says, do this, do that, your back pain will go off. You might land up in more trouble. Then, most of the common perception is that all spine surgeries are risky ones. Just like how back pains and neck pains are all not same, not all spine surgeries are same. With recent advances of medicine, there are more safer options and more options to treat you without any surgery. If surgery is warranted, then it means that the benefit of you going in for a surgery is much higher than the risk. It means you will feel much, much better when you come out of surgery. In regards to the indication for surgery, whether it is pain, numbness or weakness, whatever it is, only if you are going to improve, a doctor is going to suggest you for a surgery. So, if at all, if you have any doubts regarding the surgery, ask well before to the doctor, discuss with them, and have full faith before you land up in a surgery. And most of the surgeries do not require you to be in the bed for more than a day. When I do surgery, I like to make them move at the earliest, immediately when they regain their full consciousness and the anesthetic effect is weaned off, say around 6 hours after the surgery, I'll try to make them move so that they'll feel more comfortable, they'll feel more happier, and the happier the patient is, the faster will be their recovery. Most common doubts that people ask when we suggest them for a surgery is that first thing, whether it is risky. The risk involved in a simple spine surgery like discectomy or microdiscectomy or microscopic discectomy, endoscopic discectomy, everything else, less than 1%. All the complications less than 1%. Immediately, as I've said before, as soon as patient is comfortable, they'll be made to walk. There is nothing called as bed rest after these simple discectomy procedures. We want you to walk back as much as tolerated. In the sense, the more you walk, the better you are. There are no major restrictions after spine discectomy surgeries. You can walk, you can sit, you can lie down any way you want, you can climb steps, you can travel for a few minutes or nearby places or from the hospital to your home in a car. Few things that are better avoided are bending forward, lifting weights, and sitting on the floor for the next 6 weeks. After 6 weeks, we'll teach you some spine exercises to strengthen your back so that you don't develop a similar back pain in the future. Next. Then is the MRI. Many people think just because a doctor asks for an MRI, they will land up in surgery. MRI gives us a clue how to treat you better with medical management, with medicines or physio or any other modalities, or is there no scope for that and only a surgery is going to be the end option. So MRI, based on that, we can judge how well will you improve and how fast can you improve with what kind of treatment that we have to give you. In an MRI, disc bulges are pretty common. And just because a disc bulge is there, you don't have to worry. Only if they are giving you any trouble, they have to be dealt with. So just don't go by the reports and think that you have disc bulges in so many places, you are going to be bedridden or your future is doomed. Disc bulges are very, very common findings in an MRI. Even for a normal people, if you do an MRI, out of 10, 5 to 8 will have a disc bulge without having any back or neck pain. So don't go by the reports. Always discuss with the doctor and he will be knowing better which disc is causing you trouble, or is there something else in your MRI or in your body that is causing you the trouble. And all other findings can be ignored as long as they are not causing you any trouble. Next comes the physio part. Physiotherapy has two components. One is wherein they will do something on you. Next is the one wherein you have to do. In physiotherapy, they will give you some feet applications, stretchers, various machines will be there that will give you some heat applications and stimulations. That is their part. The next major part is you involving yourself. Like doing exercises. The more you do exercises as prescribed, the faster you will recover. Either after surgery or during the course of treatment with medicines. Unless we get the cooperation from you, we won't be able to see any result from you. Regarding rehabilitation, that is, okay, I have landed up in a surgery. What should I, what changes should I do in my life so that I won't get back to a similar kind of a problem in my neck or back? Maintain a proper posture when you are sitting and doing work, when you are standing and doing work. Do the exercises regularly as prescribed by the doctor and physiotherapist. Ideal weight is very, very important so that you don't develop any neck or back pain. Quit smoking. Smoking has a high correlation for a disc bulge to occur. Don't enter into any high core exercises unless you start with the basic stretches. Any hiking or jumping or what high value games you want to play, before that you do some stretches so that your body adapts to what you're going to give it the next. Be active. A sedentary lifestyle is always prone to cause you some back or neck pain. a commonest among ailment that a person can get in their lifetime is one is headache, the next commonest thing is backache. And commonest among the backache is muscle catch or strain, which goes off with rest and medications. So don't worry at all if you get a back or neck pain. Try with some ointments, a bed rest and hot water pack at home. If it doesn't settle, consult an orthopedic surgeon or a spine surgeon who is nearest to you and follow their advices so that you will be back to your regular activities. Be positive, stay healthy. If any questions are there, do post me. I will be happy to reply them. Thank you.